Right. So, following my video yesterday regarding Keir Starmer finally coming out of the not really very closed closet regarding his being a Tory, admitting it, still there are some people prepared not only to think he's still better, still different, but are prepared to keep on saying it, as if we, the people who've been calling him out for years now for his lies and his deceit and his dishonesty, are suddenly going to shut up and stop pointing out the fact he blatantly isn't, because the signs have been there for so long, it's silly. We've got the receipts. For a start, he came into the Labour leadership on the back of 10 pledges and saying he was going to make the moral case for socialism, the heir to Corbyn as he presented himself. And now he's saying he's going to be Tony Blair on steroids. He came in pretending to be on the left, where in actual fact he's to the right of many Tories, not least John Major, who just last week called both him and Sunak out for the rightward lurch the country has gone in. He promised to increase income tax for the top 5% of earners. He's gone back on that. He pledged to crack down on tax avoidance and hike corporation tax, but has instead spelled out how he'll send benefit cheats to jail for 10 years. He promised to abolish the failed universal credit. He lied. He's not going to. He promised to make health as important as economic growth, yet has instead taken private health donations, taking the money of those who want to take it over. And you don't take their money unless they're paying for something. He brings his mother, the nurse, up constantly, having said he promised her whilst she was ill that the NHS would stay public under him, yet now wants more private health to apparently support the NHS when the private sector is incapable and lacks the resources or capacity to do so. Did he lie to his own mother, in which case, as well as us? Starmer and his equally nasal minion, Rachel Reeves, talk about being on the side of working people. They repeat the mantra, working people, over and over again, ignoring those not in work and not able to work, implying that just like the Tories, they aren't on the side of the long-term sick or the disabled or the out of work. And indeed, they are only on the side of working people for as long as they are actually working and don't go on strike, heaven forbid, because you won't see Starmer on a picket line for dust, and will in fact sack shadow ministers, as we've already seen him do. Starmer won't repeal the public order bill that saw protesters arrested at the coronation, despite the fact it has now, in effect, rendered protest illegal and could, in fact, be used against striking workers. The entire law, a flagrant abuse of human rights. A human rights barrister, Keir Starmer, folks, let's not forget, and he won't defend the right to protest and has done so repeatedly. He has also opted to keep Suella Braverman's illegal migration bill, should he attain power, which the International Court of Human Rights is almost certain to find illegal because, for one, human rights clearly do not matter to him, and for two, he thinks it won't interfere with Labour's immigration plans. So God knows what they're going to be, because presumably they're going to keep deporting people as well then. He promised to abolish tuition fees. He lied. He promised to put climate at the heart of everything he does, yet stands content to see environment protesters arrested and ignores young people concerned about the environment when they try to talk to him directly as he walks off and shunning them. So he's shunning the youth vote, which Corbyn brought in. But then he's shunning everybody in one way or another, except it seems the people who are determined this consummate liar and self-professed Tory is still an honest person and will be different. He says he won't get involved in any more illegal wars. So confessing to being Tony Blair on steroids might not make people think that way necessarily. They might still remember 1 million dead Iraqis whose deaths were led to by that warmonger's lies. Starmer, lest we forget, was demanding we start World War III not all that long ago when war broke out in Ukraine, wanting to send all manner of weaponry and materials over to Ukraine, wanting to put boots on the ground before the idiot was informed that NATO couldn't do that. And that's despite him crowing NATO is Labour's greatest achievement, clearly showing he doesn't even understand what NATO really is and what it's about, and is just aping the words coming from Peter Mandelson's various orifices when the reality is the NHS is Labour's greatest achievement, and Starmer will just let that be privatised instead. If he was so anti-war and pro-peace, he'd also be damn well calling out Israel for what they do in Palestine. But when he and so many other right-wing Blairites are Israel-funded, not least members of the Labour NEC as well, such as Luke Akehurst, paid to promote Israeli interests, you can see this is another example of Starmer and co. having been bought and paid for donor-style, just like the Tories, because as they've shown and now publicly announced, they are Tories too. Starmer promised common ownership of public services. Now the only service he's still committed to renationalising, although if you ask him, the two terms don't mean the same thing, is rail, as and when franchises end. Despite the Tories having already been doing this, just about to do the same thing again with Transpennine, Not that you've heard a lot about that, because around half of all rail lines now have been renationalised in to a certain degree, because privatisation always fails, of course. It, God forbid, the public get wind of this scam, of this revelation that's going on behind closed doors. Instead of renationalising energy, Starmer would instead set up another energy company, GB Energy. It sounded great on the front first, on the, you know, when he first presented it, publicly owned and all the rest of that, but which will in fact only be a generator and distributor of energy to the energy companies, which are already scalping us, and not be a direct supplier to us. So it's a big fat Tory-style con as well, where profiteers will continue to be allowed to profiteer. Our water companies need renationalising as well, but he won't do that anymore either. Our rivers are full of shit. Our ecology is dying or is already dead in our rivers, much like any semblance of change in government should Starmer be elected Prime Minister would be. Now, I've already mentioned the illegal migrants bill being kept, which doesn't gel whatsoever with Starmer's pledge to defend migrant rights when he's keeping deportation, it seems, on the statute books. Though I guess deportation will help him close those detention centres such as Jarlswood that he pledged to. He won't need them if people aren't here anymore, after all. He wants to strengthen ties with trade unions, despite refusing to stand on picket lines with them in solidarity, despite a founding Labour trade union and the Bakers Union already having disaffiliated as a direct result of Keir Starmer being a bloody Tory. He wants to repeal the Trade Union Act of 2016, which sounds great, but will he? I doubt it. And anti-trade union laws need repealing all the way back to Thatcher, not the last few years. So this goes nowhere near far enough. And given his keeping of anti-protest legislation now, his aversion to appearing on picket lines, he isn't on the side of workers, no matter what he and Reeves might say. You cannot believe a word he says. He's given people ample evidence to not trust a word he says, having broken his word so many times, lying to us all. Have I not given you enough evidence of that so far, after all, you might be thinking? Well, if not, have a little bit more then. He pledged to abolish the House of Lords. He lied. He wants to improve equality, yet has disproportionately purged more BAME members from his party than anyone else, not least candidates standing for local election in areas he then went on to lose seats because of it. His weaponization of anti-Semitism as an excuse to do so. His, in many cases, his purging of left-wingers, notable for the purging of a great many left-wing Jews, of which more Jews have been purged under Starmer's tenure from the Labour Party than under any other leader. His treatment of anti-Semitism is more important than all other forms of racism, utterly undermined in doing that, but still it is apparently treated as more important than any other form of racism, as shown on his own party complaints page, as anti-Semitism gets a bespoke complaints line, whereas no other form of abuse does. Why is it more important, and how can you be seen as being on the side of Jewish people when you've purged so many of them from Labour? Are they the wrong sort? Why do you fail on other equality issues? It was all there in the Ford report, which made dozens of recommendations, all of which Starmer has ignored. He promised to be an effective opposition to the Tories. Instead, he's become nicknamed Sir Abstains a lot because he literally doesn't oppose them. And now you'll know why, because frankly, he'd be more at home on those benches than he would Labour's. A cuckoo in the nest, eliminating everything that made Labour, Labour, democratic socialism, and replacing it with neoliberalism and fat, big fat flags sticking out of every hole with nary a fag paper's difference between his party and the party he pretends to oppose. His opposition to the Tories in power, entirely fueled by a desire to replace them, not to be any bloody different from them. This is a man who used to say he was against the monarchy, and now he's sat there sucking the farts from Charles's arse, who trades on his father being working class and a toolmaker when his dad owned the factory, apparently, and the biggest tool he ever made was a spanner we call Keith. This is a man who continues to defend the Met Police despite the litany of failures they have to their name, and not least the conduct of officers caught up in committing egregious crimes themselves, from rape to murder. This is a man who gave Cressida Dick his utmost support before she ended up leaving in disgrace. This is the man who let the killers of John Charles de Menezes off the hook, an operation Cressida Dick herself oversaw and which should have ended her career but didn't. This is a man who crows about his time as Director of Public Prosecutions, yet was widely detested and thought little of in his conduct there, his actions doing very little to improve the service. He will be remembered for going above and beyond to get Julian Assange extradited to Sweden before going on to the UK, US even, for the crime of being a fucking journalist. Starmer will be remembered for trying to convict someone on the basis of free speech. So what does that make him? Because it's not bloody Labour. He will be forever associated with Jimmy Savile, not for failing to prosecute him in 2009, which he was not involved in, but for failing to highlight the shortcomings of that investigation in 2011, when David Cameron ordered him to review the case. This is a man who, going into the most recent elections, decided he was so full of honesty and integrity that it'd be a good electioneering exercise to accuse Rishi Sunak of being on the side of child abusers in that they shouldn't go to prison. Obviously absurd and a lie, but it's the depths to which he has now sunk, and he went on to produce more ads from that and defended them completely. This is a man who says he stands for honesty and integrity, and honestly, his nose should grow to 3 feet long every time he claims it, because he's a liar and a cheat and a deceiver, and nothing will change if you elect him, and if you moan thereafter that you were lied to and didn't know better, well, you've been warned. Warned by me, warned by countless others in independent left media. God knows I want the Tories out. Like so many of you, they do nothing but make my life a living hell. They make all of our lives tougher. But why in God's name do you think I ought to not call out another Tory, therefore, who could replace the ones we've already got? What good is another Tory? I've skipped over the left purging by and large. I could have gone into that in far more detail. I've skipped the treatment of Jeremy Corbyn completely because it's already well known and documented. And if you think that's all good and proper, if you think this is just the rantings of a rotten lefty with a grudge, then enjoy the remaining time in the run-up to the next general election, where you're salivating at the thought of the Blue Tories going, but wanting something better to replace them rather than replacing them for the sake of it, when nothing will change in that the person in charge is no more on your side, no more likely to come up with decent policies, when he's already binned all the good stuff he promised before, destroying his reputation and any semblance of trustworthiness along with it. And don't say you weren't warned, because you have been. It's not just you he's fooling, though. Those who are loyal to him in the media and have been defending him have egg on their faces, too. Some of them are a bit hard of learning as well and are still going on to defend him. And if you stick with this channel and watch the next video here, you can see how one particular client journalist got shown up recently, courtesy of Keith. Cheers, folks.